It's Madden NFL 23 on EA Sports, and today's Clash of Conferences is just moments away. It's the Fins and the Niners. All that and more coming up next.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the so-called Silicon Valley and Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the Miami Dolphins and the San Francisco 49ers. Again, everyone, I'm Brandon Gordon. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. With me, as always, Charles Davis. And Charles, we look at a matchup like this, it's really the running backs that may take center stage here today.
And in today's football, they're still valuable, not just as runners, but guys who can catch the ball as well. It's really the number of touches that determines things these days.
Gold's got it on the tee. He kicks it off, and here we go from Levi's Stadium.
Takes it at the 7.
And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. And here comes the Miami offense now, and it's the southpaw, his third season at the wheel for the Fins. Quarterback Tua Tagovailoa.
The secret to his game and his success? Incredible chemistry with each and every one of the guys who catches passes with him. And not only does he ask them to stay after practice or meet him before practice, he actually demands it because he knows if they have that kind of chemistry built up, they're going to be hard to beat each and every ball game.
First carry for the former 49er, Raheem Mostert. Takes this up just short of the 30, but he was able to avoid that earlier tackle. Nice move. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3. But you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, 2nd and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
They try to throw on 2nd down, but this one is incomplete. He was looking for his tight end, Mike Gesicki, and it's 3rd and short.
So many things have to go right for any passing play to work out. Quarterback has to understand the defense, deliver an accurate ball. Receiver has to concentrate and bring it in. Somewhere along the assembly line, something was off with that one.
They'll try and run here with Mostert. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. They were ahead of schedule after the gain of 7 on 1st down, but the defense does not budge on 2nd and 3rd. So much for picking it up on the ground on 3rd down. 3rd play of the drive, and this defense showing strong early.
I wonder how much of that was scouting. I wonder how much of that was a gut feeling like, okay, let's just go ahead and sell out here and get after them, thinking they're going to run the football and stuff them early, because they've now set the tone. They've set a precedent right here that if you're going to try and run the ball against us, it could be hard going throughout this game.
Here's Thomas Morstead on now to punt it away on 4th down.
Back deep, Ray McLeod.
Fair catch signaled for and taken just shy of the 30-yard line.
San Francisco readying for their first drive of the game on offense. And in his 9th season in the league, 6 with the 49ers, it's Jimmy Garoppolo at quarterback.
And Jimmy Garoppolo has shown that he can be a Super Bowl quarterback, but his biggest problem, his ability to stay healthy and remain on the field. When able, he's a capable quarterback prone to winning games both in the regular and postseason.
Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10, just shy of the 30. The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey, and he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Not a lot of running room there, not a place to make a cut and kind of exit out because they had everything bottled up. Looked to me like the linemen were taking on their blocks really well and giving up no creases.
The last run got three. Now here's second and 7. How about this? They'll try the option. Left side. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. You need your wide receivers as blockers. Sometimes they get a hold.
The big runs are often a result of what they do on the perimeter. In this case, got caught holding, and this one will come back.
Another run with McCaffrey on second down.
And he'll take it forward for about 5 up to the 28-yard line.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
The Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. Looking to throw, Garoppolo. Open man is Juwan Jennings. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 15 yards there for number 15.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
From the lineman to the guy running with it, that was a well-executed first down by the offense. With 2 shots left to get the first, you can get a little aggressive here on second down if you want and try for some bigger yardage.
6 yards on that last play. Here's 2nd and 4. They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. And he's across midfield and into Miami territory.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you, and sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the play, as we just saw there.
We saw a great example of perseverance right there on that play.
Got to be careful. They might want to throw one over his head as this game progresses.
Garoppolo to throw on 3rd and 1. And this is going to be incomplete.
Certainly looked like maybe his 3rd or his 4th read on his progression. Just trying to find his outlet man that time. Ends up leading him just a bit too much.
On 4th down, the Niners trot out Mitch Wishnowski to punt the football. Back deep is Tyreek Hill. And this will be out of bounds. Now it's a question of where they'll mark it. And they'll say it crosses at the 11-yard line. So Miami coming out for their 2nd drive.
And on the 1st drive, 3 and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
No room to be had there on the 1st down run as he's lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
So after the run for no gain, here's 2nd and 10.
They run out of the shotgun with Mostert.
Oh, good move.
And he finds enough of an opening to get this one back up to his 20. Call it an 8-yard gain. Much better shape now on third and just a yard.
That's the kind of run that gets everyone excited on offense. And, you know, oftentimes the guys who carry the ball are the ones in the huddle doing the chirping. Right now I think it's the offensive line telling them, run it again. We are right there about to break a big one.
On third down, here comes Mostert.
And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage.
Well, partner, none of these runs individually have added up to a whole lot.
Now, three plays, all three short runs, but together a first down.
Yeah, it's amazing how the narrative changes when you string them together.
Tua now on first down. Got a man complete to Cedric Wilson.
A good gain on first has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29.
A run with Mostert up the middle. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Looking to pass, Tua.
And to the left side here, Wilson. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9.
We're scoreless after 1. It's Dolphins football here as we begin the second quarter, as they've got it with a 2nd and 1 coming up. Second down, Gaskin. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
2nd and 1 is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
Tua now on first down.
This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield.
And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line.
Now that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
2nd and 6.
Going to the air, Tagovailoa. And down he goes. The 49ers get there.
Nick Bosa showing his strength and quickness there. A loss of 4.
In every game we talk about what are going to be the keys as we go into it. Maybe that's a key for their defense today. Pressure the quarterback and make sure you play a good zone defense behind them, and they get their first sack of the contest.
Niners have an extra defensive back on the field, a nickel set for third down. Tua sets up to pass it. He's going to drop this underneath to Mostert. And they'll bring him down right at midfield, and he is well short of the first down. That's going to bring up fourth down, only a gain of two there.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
Now the veteran Thomas Morstead on to punt it away.
And you can't do it much better than that. This ball kicks out of bounds at the 4-yard line.
So well done there. And these punters, they get more specialized and better each and every year, don't they?
They sure do. And now it's really not the American punters. It's the Australian punters with their kicking academies and that flat drop and just kind of kicking the nose of the football. They're able to almost stop it where they want to, like a good golfer can check one up.
Now the second-year man from Louisiana, here's Elijah Mitchell.
And a nice pickup as this one gets him to the 10-yard line. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
I think they're ahead of schedule now after that run. They might be bold with this second down call after that type of a gain.
The last run got 6, now 2nd and 4. Another run, this time McCaffrey. And not much there at all, as he'll get this only up to about the 11. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 3.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Garoppolo going to try and throw on 3rd. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Every offense tells you they want to come out and start fast. That's not unusual at all. But this group, they've yet to get much rolling through their first 2 drives. It looks like they're going to have to give up the football again after this one.
So on 4th down, here's the Australian native Mitch Wishnowsky to punt this one away.
Fair catch taken just inside the 40-yard line.
So possession goes over here on the punt, and it'll be Dolphin football.
Out comes the Dolphin offense now as they get set to take over here.
And partner, I know so far, and we're still in the first half, but you love this game as a defensive guy. 0-0. We'll see if the offense can get going on this drive.
Well, you know how they talk about music to your ears? How about what it does for your eyes when you watch something like this, right, where these teams are locked in and going at it, no points going up on the scoreboard. I'm loving it. You're exactly right.
Well, switch over, though, to an offensive mindset for a moment. What do they need to do here to get on track and get some points?
I think a couple of ways. Number one, you pull out something that maybe they haven't seen before. Coaches always talk about unscouted looks. Maybe you give them something that they haven't seen on tape, and now you shock them that way. The second, run your basic playbook, but run it so well that you give your skill position guys a chance to make big plays individually.
Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. Once again, it's Mostert.
And they get him down right near the midfield stripe.
That was a good run, probably right on the edge of breaking into something really big. So the defensive guys right now are talking about, okay, what can we do to slow him down before he truly gets started?
The offense on 3rd down tonight, just 1 for 3 thus far. They're looking at 3rd in the nose of the football. From the gun, a run with Mostert. And he gets it down to the 48, enough for the first.
Yeah, they really needed to get something going, didn't they? They had punted on the last 2 possessions. The running game starting to come to the front for them, providing a nice pickup there to keep this drive going.
Throw with Tagovailoa. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Well, congratulations to them. They come through defensively with another stop. And let's face it, this secondary, they've gone unchallenged so far in the first half.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Tua gonna throw. Complete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Now Tua. He is going to find Hill here. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 19. A first down and then some. Give him 29 yards.
I don't care how many times we say it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
On first and 10, it's Mostert. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. It'll be a 5-yard pickup there, and it will take us to the 2-minute warning. Ball at the 14 for second and 5. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. The pressure from multiple guys there as they bury him for a big 9-yard loss.
And another long drive from the offense, but the defense is denying them the end zone. Nothing to show for the last drive offensively. They can't come away empty-handed again.
So now after the sack, Tua and the Dolphins staring at a third and long. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. And that is incomplete. Oh, he did everything but hold on to it. But a nice play defensively, and now it brings up fourth down.
Coverage was awfully tight there on third down. They actually closed off all the passing lanes, forcing the incompletion and bringing up fourth down.
So fourth down, Tua departs, and on is Jason Sanders and the Dolphin field goal unit. The kick by Sanders is good. And we have action on the scoreboard just before halftime. It's 3-0. Well, both teams kind of feeling each other out here. And now after three drives, we have a score with that field goal.
Yeah, they're still waiting for their breakout drive to come to them, all right? They're using the playbook well. They're looking for that extra section that says touchdowns instead of field goals. But they'll take the three for now and try and get set up for more later.
After the field goal, here comes Sanders to kick it away. This will be fielded inside the 5. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. And now this offense comes back out onto the field. And in a spot like this, still more than a minute, I think if you put something on the board before halftime, that would go a long way towards helping them get back into the game.
There actually is something to the psychology of the game at times, isn't there? How much better would they feel running into the locker room, as you noted, with something on the board in a positive fashion? You're exactly right. It's a great opportunity to get that done.
Throwing on first is Garoppolo. Got a man right side, it's McCaffrey. And he'll be out of bounds at the 25-yard line. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And that's going to bring up second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
To throw again on second down, Garoppolo. Man open, that's Deebo Samuel. And they work this well upfield across the 45. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Looking to throw, Garoppolo. Again, he'll find Samuel for the completion. Now another timeout called for by the offense as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Looking to throw again on second down, Garoppolo. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Could we get a touchdown in this first half after all? It's first and 10. Garoppolo again. And he'll just get rid of it.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game. It has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Here's Garoppolo to throw. That's caught downfield by Kittle. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. And now the Niners going to signal for their third and final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. Now a first and 10 at the 11. To throw is Garoppolo. He'll get this out wide here to McCaffrey. Oh, he's brought down. And remember here, no timeouts left. They got to get to the line quick. Just a gain of a yard in what all likelihood will be the final play of the first half. So we've hit halftime. Just a field goal separating these two teams at the break. As we send you cross-country to Orlando, Jonathan Coachman is there and has our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome in everyone to our downtown Orlando studios and this EA Sports Halftime Report. First, though, time for a check of the next-gen stats from that first half for Miami. And even though they've got the lead, they're likely going over ways they can improve the running game, as they didn't find a whole lot of success in those first two quarters. Meanwhile, for the Niners, they too didn't do a whole lot in terms of rushing efficiency in that first half, as you can tell by the numbers there.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three.
Yeah.
These offenses seemingly still back at the hotel for the first half. 3-0 our score as the second half gets underway.
Taking in at the three. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The 49er offense set to go to begin quarter number three. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well, and they've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
One thing I have learned, receivers don't mind high throws so much to the sideline, but do that over the middle to them, and not only are the DBs going to throw a little verbal trash their way, when they get back to the huddle, they have a few words to say to their QB, aren't they?
Yeah, hung out to dry a little bit there on the high throw. Luckily, fell incomplete. And this is caught, Jennings. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. 22 yards there, a first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Play action, Garoppolo. Gets this one to Juszczyk. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49. It'll go as a gain of 4, and it'll be second down.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the next step in utilizing this position is to actually utilize more of a scat back in this spot, because we saw the catch there, right? He made it, but he's a bigger, stronger guy, maybe not quite as elusive as maybe someone else you would put
there. Yeah, didn't get the big yardage there you might out of a smaller back. Again, they'll throw with Garoppolo. That's complete. It's Brandon Ayuk. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Off the option, here's McCaffrey. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and a yard. They run with McCaffrey off the option. Slipped one tackle, but no more as he's knocked to the deck behind the line of scrimmage. They go backwards there 2 yards, and 2nd and 1 is now 3rd and 3.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
7th play of the drive now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. How about this? They'll try the option. Left side. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. Nothing doing on 2nd and 3rd down after that 9-yard gain on 1st.
I see a shake of the head as he gets up, and you've got to imagine he's thinking, guys, you got to help me out. He's hoping his team can read his thoughts because he definitely needs some assistance.
So now they're going to send out the field goal unit to, as they say, fire away from long distance. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. And that will tie us at 3-3. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. So here are the Dolphins now. They get ready for their first possession of the second half. And their three-point halftime lead gone now, back to a tie game. But, Charles, I don't imagine that changes too much for this offense.
I would agree. I don't think it changes much at all, whether it's a three-point lead or a tie game. They know they have their work cut out for them, and they were going to run their offense in the same vein.
Tagovailoa and the Dolphins come up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. He'll look to Mostert to start things out. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Oh, that was a thing of beauty right there. Look at how quick those blockers fired off the line once the ball was snapped. That was an O-line on a mission, all in sync, and the defense is lucky that play only picked up 5 yards.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Again, they'll run it with Mostert. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 51 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now.
Now that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork and handling a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Here's Tua. He'll get this to his tight end, Gesicki. Just a gain of a couple there. And that will bring up 2nd down.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
On play action, here's Tua. This one finds Wilson downfield. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. A 1st down there on a pickup of 25.
Now what we're seeing, this is much better from this offense because so far in this game, no touchdown to this point. And what's usually a direct correlation? Very few explosive plays. That's been their issue, not able to make that big shot downfield or break one off, but a nice game there for a 1st down.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, 1st and 10. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. He'll swing this out to Mostert. 2 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
From the 31, Tua. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he'll be taken down at about the 22-yard line.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
Now a give to Mostert running right. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
A 2nd down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
Oh, I saw this one with defensive eyes because even as he escaped the pocket and bought time, the coverage stayed tight. Nothing broke down. Throwing it away, that was his only option.
Play number 9 on the drive coming up, and they need 9 yards on 3rd down.
Looking to pass. Tua. He's going to drop this underneath to Mostert. And he's going to be taken down short of the first, right around the 15-yard line. That one good for only six, and it leaves him with a fourth down.
How about that strategy there, Brandon? Third down, they just said, we've got faith in our tackles. We'll give you the short stuff, and just decided to protect the sticks. So every time I hear fans telling me tackling's not a part of the game anymore, plays like that, I can clip and save and show them you have to tackle well if you want to be a good defense.
They'll go. It's Gaskin. And he won't get there. They stop him a few yards short of the line to gain. The Dolphins can't convert on fourth down. And the 49ers are going to get the football back. And they've now made two trips to the red zone and still looking for their first touchdown.
Not able to punch it in. And if you're on defense, your confidence is sky high. Because mentally, you're saying, hey, you're in the red zone. We're thinking we're giving up three. We just want to give up six. In this case, they end up not giving up the touchdown at all. They've got to feel great about what they got done.
Now, meanwhile, a final play here is incomplete, and that's going to take us to the end of the third quarter of play. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Out of the pistol, McCaffrey. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
And this offense on third down today, they've only converted once in four tries. This is third and four. Now Garoppolo. And that will be incomplete.
This is such a good first touch of this game. That's not going to achieve that at all. Give victory to the secondary there. They brought out tight coverage on that third down snap.
Here comes the 49ers punter now, as he's on to kick it away. And this returnable for Hill. They call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Dolphins offense now ready to go back out onto the field. Excellent job by their defense to force the punt and provide them with this opportunity, all tied in the fourth quarter. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 on their side of midfield at the 47. Now a short one to Gesicki. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. 3 yards remain for second down. Now Tua completes it to the tight end, Smythe. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line. The start for them near flawless. Defense gets him a three and out. Two quick pass connections on offense.
So that's how a team works together. Just what you described. Get them the ball, give them a little momentum, and they're capitalizing off of that. Thanks a lot, guys.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. On a jet sweep, here comes Waddle. And he's got some space here. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
I think the reason that this play is so successful is not just the blocking at the point of attack, but how about the speed at which he takes the handoff? He's in motion already, so he's not coming from a flat start like a running back often is. He's at a full run by the time he gets the football.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Running the counter with Mostert.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle. That's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
He shook his head right when he released that throw. He knew it was going to be a little off target.
Yeah, the excitement got him on that one. Wasn't able to control the fact the receiver was open, and it would have been an easy throw.
An incomplete pass on second down. It muddles things a little bit here. This is third and 10.
A handoff running left is Mostert.
Call it a gain of three, and it'll bring up fourth down. Have to kick this field goal, don't you?
No question about it. Look at the clock. Look at the situation. Kick the field goal.
So a big one coming now for Jason Sanders. This to break our fourth quarter tie. Sanders' kick is good, and the Dolphins have taken the lead here in the fourth. We still wait on the first touchdown of the game, but a second field goal now makes it a 6-3 score.
Yeah, I know a lot of people would call this the definition of winning ugly. To me, this is gorgeous. I'm a defender, right? I love these kind of games. The tension is high. Who's going to make the play to win it? And right now, that field goal may be the advantage that they need.
After the field goal, here comes Sanders to kick it away.
The football will come out to the 25 as McLeod will not return it.
Out on the field now, here come the 49ers.
And now they find themselves trailing following the field goal. Still a good amount of time in this fourth quarter, but this drive very well could determine the outcome of this ball game.
Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Completes it to Jennings. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Throwing again on second down, Garoppolo.
Garoppolo to Ayuk, first down 49ers.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line.
Mike McGlinchey, the Notre Dame man, guilty on that one.
They're backed up here with a first and 20 now after the holding penalty. Looking to throw, Garoppolo. This will be caught. It's Samuel.
It's a big play, yet amazingly, because of how far they had to go, they're still looking at a second down here. Now a give, right side McCaffrey. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. 40 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. They'll find Ayuk open right side. And the tackle going to be made at the 38.
That completion helps out in a nice way. Now they can take a little bit more time, but guess what? They've got to make sure on their throws that they see it open, not just anticipate it.
The 49ers moving hastily. They're scurrying to the line. Now Garoppolo. And his throw is incomplete. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark really start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is it just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
Third down, trying to get a little bit closer. From here, the field goal would be 55 yards. To throw is Garoppolo. Completes it to Samuel. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 24-yard line. 13 yards as the quick slant keeps the drive moving.
I'm starting to wonder here, are they trying to prevent winning? Because right now, they're laying back and they're picking them apart, moving the ball downfield. I think they got to start bringing a little pressure towards the quarterback.
First down now, but the clock continues to move. Now here's a throw that's complete. And they'll get this down to the 10. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown, and that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Garoppolo to throw. Throw left side, McCaffrey's got it. And inside the 5 here before he's out of bounds right at the 3. A gain of 7 that time. Second goal. Back to throw. Garoppolo. And this is caught. Touchdown. And they've taken the lead here in the final minute.
What an outstanding drive right there to take the lead. And also, Charles, didn't leave their opposition with a whole lot of time on the clock.
Yeah, I like the way that you're viewing this because they did a tremendous job to put themselves in a position to win. But they can't celebrate just yet. They've got to clamp down on any big plays and force them to use up those timeouts without making any headway.
Robbie Gould on for the extra point. And he's got it as the lead is now 10-6. The 10-play drive that time.
And it's capped off by the late touchdown that puts him out in front here in the final minute of the contest.
after the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away.
From the six.
Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here. There he goes, left side. And he'll bring it back all the way. Touchdown, Miami.
Well, that is the definition, Charles, of delivering under pressure. The game-winning potential. There's still a little time left on the clock, but the potential game-winning drive, and it was well executed.
I think we're going to remember this possession for a long time. We've called a bunch of games, but how about how they got it done down the stretch? Absolutely terrific. Barring some type of miraculous play in this last half minute, I think that touchdown just earned them the win. They really came up clutch when they needed it.
So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff.
From the six. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive.
Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball.
Yeah, why?
I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
One final try now for Garoppolo. He's got a man complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
And a fun, close ball game comes to an end. On that last play, Charles, they were on the wrong side of midfield. They needed something near a miracle, and they couldn't get it done.
Yeah, the effort. That was good. Very good, in fact. They were just a little too far out to get a decent look at the end zone for that last opportunity. Couldn't get it done, but a nice game overall.